हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू स्टडी मैक एजुकेशन चैनल। एंड टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट एमसीक्यू फॉर मैकेनिकल इंजीनियरिंग विद सॉल्यूशन पार्ट 7। सो लेट्स बिगिन आवर क्वेश्चन ओवर हियर। ओपन साइकिल गैस टर्बाइन वर्क्स ऑन, आवर ऑप्शन आर कार्नोट साइकिल, ऑप्शन बी रैंकिन साइकिल, ऑप्शन सी जूल साइकिल एंड ऑप्शन डी ब्रेटन साइकिल। एज वी नो जूल साइकिल एंड ब्रेटन साइकिल बोथ आर सेम एंड ओपन साइकिल गैस टर्बाइन वर्क्स ऑन जूल साइकिल। सो आवर राइट आंसर ओवर हियर इज जूल साइकिल। ब्रेटन साइकिल इज ऑल्सो राइट आंसर, बट ओवर हियर द प्रॉपर आंसर इज जूल साइकिल। सो रिमेंबर दिस। नाउ फॉर जूल साइकिल वी हैव टू रिमेंबर, इन रिवर्स जूल साइकिल इट इज वर्क फॉर एयर रेफ्रिजरेशन सिस्टम। इन एयर रेफ्रिजरेशन सिस्टम द थ्रू आउट द सिस्टम द रेफ्रिजरेंट विल इज रिमेन एयर इन फेज। सो रिमेंबर दिस इंफॉर्मेशन। नाउ फॉर रिवर्स ब्रेटन साइकिल इट इज ऑल्सो नोन एज बेल कोलमन साइकिल। सो रिमेंबर दिस इंफॉर्मेशन। नाउ लेट्स डिस्कस अबाउट रैंकिन साइकिल। रैंकिन साइकिल इज मेनली वर्क्स इन थर्मल पावर प्लांट और वी कैन से स्टीम पावर प्लांट। एंड कार्नोट साइकिल इज नोन एज हीट इंजन साइकिल। सो डोंट कन्फ्यूज बिटवीन दिस साइकिल्स। नाउ लेट्स डिस्कस द प्रोसेस ऑफ द साइकिल इन अ शॉर्ट। इन कार्नोट साइकिल इट कंसिस्ट ऑफ फोर प्रोसेसेस एंड टू प्रोसेस आर आइसोथर्मल प्रोसेस एंड रिमेनिंग टू आर आइसेंट्रॉपिक प्रोसेस। आई रिपीट, आइसेंट्रॉपिक प्रोसेस। नाउ लेट्स डिस्कस अबाउट रैंकिन साइकिल। रैंकिन साइकिल मेनली कंसिस्ट ऑफ फाइव प्रोसेस। सो टू आर आइसोथर्मल रिमेनिंग टू आर आइसेंट्रॉपिक एंड लास्ट वन इज कॉन्स्टेंट प्रेशर, दैट इज आइसोबैरिक प्रोसेस। नाउ जूल साइकिल। जूल साइकिल मेनली कंसिस्ट ऑफ फोर प्रोसेस। इन फोर प्रोसेस टू प्रोसेस आर आइसेंट्रॉपिक प्रोसेस। आई रिपीट, आइसेंट्रॉपिक एंड रिमेनिंग टू आर आइसोबैरिक। सो दैट मीन्स कॉन्स्टेंट प्रेशर, आइसोबैरिक प्रोसेस। नाउ ब्रेटन साइकिल। ब्रेटन साइकिल इज ऑल्सो नोन एज जूल साइकिल, सो डोंट कन्फ्यूज बिटवीन जूल साइकिल एंड ब्रेटन साइकिल। नाउ लेट्स डिस्कस फॉर नेक्स्ट डिटेल्स। आवर क्वेश्चन ओवर हियर, अ क्रिटिकल पॉइंट प्रेशर 225.65 केजी पर सीएम स्क्वेयर, द लेटेंट एंथैल्पी ऑफ वेपराइजेशन। फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल एंथैल्पी दैट वी नो एच इज इक्वल टू यू प्लस पी वी, इट इज अ समेशन ऑफ इंटरनल एनर्जी प्लस प्रोडक्ट ऑफ प्रेशर एंड वॉल्यूम। लेट्स कॉन्सेंट्रेट ऑन द क्वेश्चन अगेन। आवर क्वेश्चन इज एट क्रिटिकल पॉइंट P is equal to 225.65 kg per cm square, the latent enthalpy of vaporization is, our options are A 225.65, option B 0, option C 1000 and option D high. So our right answer over here is B 0. So remember these details. Now let's move to the next question. Our next question is a steady rest in a lathe. First of all, for lathe we have to remember lathe is the mother of all machine. Lathe is mother of all machine because we can perform 25 basic operation on lathe. So this is the most important reason for lathe is the mother of all machine. So now let's focus on the question. A steady rest is the lathe unit that is used for our option R, holding very long and heavy job, option B external taper turning, option C performing the knurling operation and option D supporting the bed. Our right answer over here is option A, holding very long and heavy job. Now let's discuss in this figure. As we can see, this is our chuck. I am overlapping here, and over here we have workpiece which is very long and heavy. So in right side figure we can see there are bearings which support our workpiece, and it allow to the workpiece to freely move in its own axis. So steady rest, we are clear about steady rest. What is the steady rest in a lathe? Now let's discuss over here taper turning. For taper turning we have to remember one equation. If you want to find angle of taper, then tan alpha is equal to capital D plus small d divided by twice L. Now what is the equation suggest itself? Suppose this is our cylindrical workpiece and we want to make a taper on this workpiece. Now over here, this larger diameter is capital D, smaller diameter is small d, and the length is known as L. So I think if we are clear for this equation, we can find the taper angle. Whatever the taper develop over here, we can find this taper angle, which is known as alpha. Now let's move to the next detail. Our next question is, hot wire anemometer is used to measure. Our option are A, liquid discharge, option B, pressure liquid, option D, pressure in gases. Now we have to remember over here that hot wire anemometer is used to measure gas velocities. So remember this option, option C is our right answer. Now let's discuss about bomb calorimeter. These details are very very important for exam point of view. Sometimes MCQ will direct come from these details. Bomb calorimeter is used to measure solid as well as liquid. I repeat, solid and liquid material calorific value. To measure calorific value of solid and liquid, bomb calorimeter device is used. And for Junker calorimeter is used for to measure gas calorific value. To measure calorific value of gas, Junker calorimeter is used. Now let's discuss about pitot tube. Pitot tube is used to measure, let me clear all this. Pitot tube is used to measure fluid velocity. So remember this detail. Now rotameter. Rotameter is mainly used for rotameter is used to measure, remember, volumetric flow of liquid and gases. I repeat, rotameter is a device which is used to measure volumetric flow of liquid and gas. Now venturimeter and orifice meter are basically used to measure flow rate. Remember this, venturimeter and orifice meter is used to measure flow rate, rotameter is used to measure volumetric flow of liquid and gas, and pitot tube is used to measure fluid velocity, Junker calorimeter is used to measure gas calorific value, and bomb calorimeter is used to measure solid and liquid calorific value. Now let's move to the next detail. Over here, as we know, thermometer is used to measure temperature, and it works on zeroth law of thermodynamics. As we know, it is a law of equilibrium for temperature. Now pyrometer is used to measure the temperature of surface. So remember, for pyrometer is used for to measure surface temperature. Now next is hygrometer. Hygrometer is used to measure moisture content available in the atmosphere. Or most important, remember, hydrometer or aerometer is used to measure the specific gravity of liquids. Remember. Now psychrometer is used to measure the amount of humidity, as well as psychrometer is also used for dry bulb temperature as well as wet bulb temperature. So we have to remember all these details over here, very very important for exam point of view. Now let's discuss the next detail, next question. Which of the following is not a part of Schaefer? So first of all, we should know how Schaefer machine is look like. So let's discuss about the figure. Over here we can see the parts of Schaefer machine. First of all, this is our base, elevated screw from which we can elevate the table. Now cross feed, over here the cross feed unit, so we can give the cross feed. Now let me zoom over here. This is dovetail type arrangement, which is a cross light, or in this attachment there is a ram. This is over here tool head which is our contain feed hand wheel, and at this side, left side, the clapper box in which we can fix our tool, and over here there is a table. So let's focus on the question. Which of the following is not part of Schaefer? Table is a part of Schaefer. Knee is not part of Schaefer. Cross slide is also part of Schaefer, and ram. Yes, ram is also part of Schaefer machine. So over here, knee is our right answer. Let's focus on the question again. What is the details given in the question? Which of the following is not a part of Schaefer? So our right answer is knee. Knee is not a part of sapper. Now let's move to the next detail. Our next question is, what does symbol D imply in work study? As we know, for work study, O stand for operation. Remember this detail. And square is stand for inspection. Inspection. And D stand for delay. And the inverted triangle is stand for storage. And the remaining one, arrow. Arrow stand for transport. So we have to remember all the symbols and its meaning. Now let's focus on the question, what does symbol D imply in the work study? Let's see the option. Option A, transport. For transport, as we know, the symbol is arrow. For option C, dummy transport, which is same. For option B, delay, temporary storage. For delay, our option is D. And for storage, option is inverted triangle. And for inspection, our right option is square. But over here, let's focus on the question again. What does symbol D imply in the work study? So our suitable answer is B. Over here, B is our right answer. Delay, temporary storage. So D is the right answer. So option B is our right answer. Now let's focus on the next question. Our next question is, which of the following welding process use non-consumable electrode? Very easy question. Non-consumable electrode means tungsten inert gas welding. Tungsten inert gas welding use argon gas or helium gas because they both are inert gases. Now as we know, for MIG it is known as consumable electrode process. Consumable process, sorry, we remember this. Our right option is D, tungsten inert gas welding. Manual arc welding is not a non-consumable process. Submerged arc welding is also not a non-consumable process. So our right option is D. Now let's move to the next detail. Steam coming out of whistle of pressure cooker. First of all, for pressure cooker, we have to remember the pressure available is 1.1 to 1.3 bar, which is more than atmospheric pressure. Now let's focus on the question. Steam coming out of whistle of pressure cooker. Our option are wet vapor, option C ideal gas, option C superheated vapor, and option D dry saturated vapor. Superheated vapor is basically used for a boiler. Our pressure cooker is also boiler, but the pressure available in cooker is 1.1 to 1.3. So over here, our right answer for this question is A, wet vapor. I repeat the question. In steam, the steam coming out of whistle of pressure cooker is option A, wet vapor. So remember this answer. Now let's move to the next detail. Our next question is, reciprocating air compressor is best suit for? Our option are small quantity of air at high pressure, option C large quantity of air at low pressure, and option B small quantity of air at low pressure, and option D large quantity of air at high pressure. First of all, we have to remember for pump. Over here the question is regarding to compressor, but if we remember for pump, then it is very easy to remember for compressor. Now let's discuss about reciprocating pump. Reciprocating pump is used for high head. Only remember this. So high head and low discharge. Okay. Now centrifugal pump is used for low head and high discharge. So remember this both difference. Now over here, let's focus on the question again, that reciprocating air compressor is best suit for small quantity of air at high pressure. Yes, this is our right answer. Small quantity of air at high pressure. So option A is our right answer. For pump and compressor, we have to remember these details. And the another important details for pump and compressor are that we must discuss over here, that is, if the blade or the rotor of a pump propeller is bent backward, then we have maximum output. And if the blade or rotor or the propeller of a compressor is bent forward, then we have maximum output. So for the case of compressor, the blade should bend to the forward, so we have maximum output. And if in case of pump, if blade are bent backward, then we have maximum output. So remember this detail, very important for exam point of view. Now let's move to the next question. The room air conditioner controls, the option are A, humidity, option B both, option D temperature, and option C none of the three mentioned here. Everybody knows the room air conditioner is used to control humidity and temperature. So option B is the right answer. So remember over here. Now let's move to the next question. The most commonly used flame in gas welding is option A oxidizing, option B carburizing, option D natural, and option C all of the three mentioned here. Well, as we know, the natural flame is used for steel and its alloy, high medium steel, low medium steel, medium steel. Then carburizing flame is used to make hard the satellite material, especially. And oxidizing flame is used to weld brass and bronze. Remember this, brass and bronze. So our right answer over here is D, natural flame. So for the most commonly used flame in a gas welding is natural flame. Now let's move to the next question. The internal energy of ideal gas is a function of option A pressure, option B temperature and pressure, option C temperature and volume, and option D temperature. As we know, the internal energy of ideal gas is a function of temperature only. So option D is our right answer. So remember this. Now let's move to the next question. Very important. Free air is the air at option A 20 degrees Celsius and 1 kg per cm square and relative humidity 36%. Option B 25 degrees Celsius, 1 kg per cm square and relative humidity 50%. Option C 0 degrees Celsius and standard atmospheric condition. This is not a definitely right answer. Now option D, atmospheric condition at any specific location. So let's concentrate on the question. Free air is the air at, so our right answer is D, atmospheric condition at any specific location. So remember these details. Now let's discuss for remaining details. A 20 degree Celsius and 1 kg per cm square and relative humidity of 36%. So this is the case for standard air. So remember this detail. Now over here, the option B stand for 25 degrees Celsius, kg per cm square and relative humidity 50%. So this is the case for psychrometric chart circle. So this details we can use for calculation purpose. And 0 degree Celsius, this case is not possible for any right answer or any right option. Now here we have to remember another details, that for human comfort, here we have to remember, for human comfort the humidity should be 60% and temperature should be 22 degrees Celsius, or in some books it is also given 25 degrees Celsius. So remember these details. Let's rewind all the details. Option A is stand for standard air. Option B is stand for psychrometric chart, the value given on circle. And option C is not the right option. And option D is stand for our question over here. Free air is the air at option D, atmospheric condition at the specific location. So D is our right answer over here. Now let's move to the next detail. Our next question is tachometer. Tachometer are used to measure our option A acceleration, option B angular velocity. For angular velocity, as we know, omega is equal to 2 into pi into n by 60, and a unit is radian per second. Now let's discuss about question. Option D, displacement, and option C, vibration amplitude. Now let's see what is the tachometer. Tachometer are mainly two types, contact type, and this is over here non-contact type. In non-contact type, there is a laser rays which strike on the surface, and it will also come to the receiver of tachometer, so it will measure the value, and by calculating it will give the exact RPM of motor. So I think we are here about contact type and non-contact type the tachometer. So let's discuss our right answer over here. Tachometer are used to measure, our right answer is angular velocity. Remember this. Now let's move to the next detail. Well, the application of third type lever is found in, first of all, for lever we have to remember, lever has to deal with bending moment. So remember this, very very important MCQ. Now focus on the question. The application of third type lever is found in, our option are A, lever loaded safety valve, option B, hand wheel of the punching press, option C, handle of hand pump, and option D, a pair of tongue. So our right answer over here, the application of third type, remember, application of third type lever is found in a pair of tongue. So this is the example of pair of tongue. Well, the point is known as our pivot. Now let's discuss what are the types of first type and second type. So let's discuss in this figure. First of all, class 1. In class 1 type lever, the green portion is known as fulcrum. Let me write over here, the fulcrum. In class 1 type system, the fulcrum is in between load and effort. And the example of fulcrum is over here, the lever loaded safety valve. Lever loaded safety valve is the example of first type of system, which is given in this diagram. So option A, lever loaded safety valve, is the example of first type of lever system. Now let's discuss option class 2 type of lever. In class 2 type of lever, as we know, the fulcrum move toward the right side and load is in between effort and fulcrum. So this is the type of second type lever, and the example is handle of feed pump. Over here, the handle of feed pump is the example of second type lever. Now for third type, class 3. In class 3, as we know, the fulcrum move toward the left side and effort is in between fulcrum and load. So this is the example of third type lever, and it is also example of a pair of tongue. So remember these details. Now let's move to the next. Well, this is the end of the video. So we will continue upload our next video. So to be continued. If you like the content available inside the video, then please press the like button and also give the comments, because your feedbacks are very very important for us. Share this video with your engineering friends like mechanical, mechatronics and automobiles, and don't forget to subscribe this channel. To join with us for next video, please subscribe this channel. We are also available on Facebook, Twitter, LinkedIn and Google+. If you have any query and if you have any suggestion, then feel free to contact us on email studymacheducation@gmail.com, and thank you. Have a good time. Thank you.